Good morning, students. In our previous lecture, we learned the basic programming structure of your C program. Okay, so the basic structure of your C program, we learned that there are different sections, and that sections are defined. First is documentation section, second is link section, third is define section, fourth is global declaration, fifth is main section. Then in main section there are again two parts, declaration and executable parts. So here we by using that section, if you have gone through that lecture, you will understand ki what is actually the section. So on the basis of that section, in this session we actually learn how to develop a program. So to we will learn the first programming in our C language. So document section, as I told you, document section is a line, non-executable section, means that is that line is ignored by the compiler. Okay, so document section, for example, I had taken one example in that lecture, the same example I am going to explain you. Okay, so this is the document section. Here the program of addition. Okay, so program of addition, and this line, when you close this line with front slash and asterisk mark, and you close this line with asterisk mark and front slash, this is known as comment line. Okay, this sign is multiple line, multiple comment line. Okay, now if you can use single line comments also by putting double slash. Okay, so if you put the double slash in front of the line, that line is treated as a comment line. Okay, so next is link section. Link section is a preprocessor. Okay, what is link section? Link section is, in link section we have to use hash, include and the header file. Here we are using one header file, and that header file is stdio.h. Now let me explain why there is a need to add a link section. Okay, so why there is a need to include this library files along with your programs. Okay, so here we are going to learn n number of functions in C programming, and the definition of that function, the syntax of that function is given in this file. Okay, so compiler need that instructions. Okay, compiler क्या करता है, आपने जो भी लिखा वो इस फाइल में जो इंस्ट्रक्शंस दिए हैं उससे कंपेयर करता है. अगर आपने सही लिखा है, सपोज इफ इट मैच विद दिस, देन इट विल एग्जीक्यूटेड. क्योंकि इस फाइल में उसे सारे इंस्ट्रक्शंस दिए हुए हैं कि मीन्स व्हाट टू डू ऑन व्हाट इंस्ट्रक्शंस, क्या करना है कौन से इंस्ट्रक्शंस पर. So we need to include the file whenever we are going to use some function. Here we are going to use one function, that is output function, that is printf. Okay, so here we will write letter. Okay, then next is the define section, which we can skip for the in our primary level. We will use letter, we will discuss that point letter in our lecture. Okay, so here in after declaration I am using your main program, main function. Okay, what do you mean by main function? See, every program must return in a main function. Main function is a executable function. See, when the compiler read this instructions, what will happen? It read this statement, but this statement is a non-executable statement, so it will not convert into machine level language. Then it read that hash include stdio.h. It is also not executable. Why? Because it is a processor, pre-processor. It is also known as pre-processor. Why? Because before converting the whole program into machine level language, you need to attach this file with your program. Okay, so whenever the compiler needed that this file, then the compiler will use this file. Okay, file which you include with your program. Okay, for example, अगर हमें कोई इंस्ट्रक्शंस देना है तो हम एक अटैचमेंट लगाते हैं, बराबर है? सो वैसे ही यहाँ पे हम जो भी फंक्शंस यूज करेंगे उसके इंस्ट्रक्शंस के लिए उसका डेफिनेशन ये फाइल में दिया है और उसके लिए हमने इसको लिंक अप किया है बिकॉज दीज फाइल्स आर स्टोर्ड इन अ सी लाइब्रेरी. सो यू कैन नॉट यूज दैट फाइल्स डायरेक्टली, यू हैव टू लिंक दैट फाइल अलोंग विद योर प्रोग्राम. Okay, in main function, I told you there are four sections and the section is, first is declaration section, second is initialization, third is processing, and the last is output. Okay, so what do you mean by declaration? Now in this lecture we will learn about all this section. What is declaration? See, the declaration is nothing but the declaration about the variable. Okay, so for addition, if you want to do the addition of three numbers, okay, so addition of three numbers, suppose 10, 20 and 30. Okay, so 10, 20, 30 are three numbers where you are going to add them. Okay, so these numbers means this is your data, and the data need to store somewhere in the memory location before it is going to use in your program. Okay, so 10, 20, 30. So here you want to store this data in a memory location, but it cannot store to directly. What you have to, first you have to occupy some space in the memory location. Suppose this is your memory location where you have n number of bytes. Okay, so here you need a space, you need to reserve some space. Okay, but to reserve some space you need a name. कौन से नाम से जगह वहां पे रिजर्व होगा. ओके, सो यहाँ पे हम लोग यहाँ पे क्या करते हैं, इस नाम का, इस जगह का नाम रखते हैं, दैट नेम इज नोन एज वेरिएबल. सो डिक्लेरेशन डज टू थिंग्स, दैट इज द नेम ऑफ योर डेटा, दैट इज नेम ऑफ वेरिएबल, एंड दिस वेरिएबल विल होल्ड द वैल्यू. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ यू डिक्लेयर इन ए एंड ए इज इक्वल्स टू 10. Okay, so what will happen? The A, you will, this space is known as A, and when you initialize value to the variable A, okay, so that 10 is stored in a this space. Right? So is tarah se aapko pehle declaration karna hai. Theek hai? Now initialization. Initialization means nothing but giving the value. Suppose if you initialize, so you can initialize value at the time of declaration also. Okay? But if you don't initialize, if you didn't initialize the value at the time of declaration, then you can initialize value by using the assignment operator. Okay? So this is your assignment operator. The 10 is assigned to the A. Okay? Now the processing. Suppose if you declare your three variables, you can declare one or more variables. And when you declare more than one variable, every variable is separated by comma. Okay, so here we have taken four variables, that is A, B, C. So B is equals to 20, we initialize, C is equals to 30 initialize a C. So when you declare A, B, C, D, so here as A, B, C, D is an integer occupies 4 bytes, so here somewhere you will get the space to B also, you will get the space for C also, and you will get the space for D also. So when you initialize value to the B, so that B, the value will be stored at the place of B, and when you initialize the value to the C, then the value is stored at the place of C. Got it? So this is known as initialization. Now what is processing? Processing, when you process the data, so what kind of processing we are going to use here? Addition. Okay, so you need to add this. Okay, so the processing is a plus b plus c. So what the compiler did? Compiler take the value of a, take the value of b, take the value of c, and add them and make a sum of all values. Because what you use here? Plus sign. Plus sign is the arithmetic operation which is used for addition. Okay, and this whatever the result comes, you store in a, you will assign to D. So यहाँ पे जो भी इसका result आएगा, कितना result होता है? 10 plus 20 is 30, 30 plus 30 is 60. So 60 will be stored at the place of D. Okay, so यहाँ पे इस तरह से processing होती है. अब यहाँ पे processing हो गया, then initialization हो गया, यहाँ पे declaration हो गया, output. So whatever the output comes after the process, after the processing of data, you need to print that output. So to print, here we are using one function, that is printf function. %d and d. D is your variable and %d is your format specification. So in our next lecture, when we learn the function printf, I will tell you ki why do we use %d. Okay, so here the example of your programming structures. Okay, but we need now, I will explain the declaration more clearly. So now what is declaration? Okay, so declaration, syntax of declaration. See, in our previous lecture we learned that variable, how there are some rules for the variables, that what will the name of the variable? The name of variable is always meaningful and it should follow the rules which I have told you. Okay, that the variable is not more than 31 characters, it might be alphanumeric, it is not numeric. You can use underscore sign, but you cannot use any special character. You cannot use any keywords. You cannot use backslash character as a variable. Okay, so you must learn these things. Okay, so declaration of variable. Declaration of variable. So the syntax of declaration is data type and variable and semicolon. See, in C, every statement you use a semicolon. Semicolon is indicate the end of the statements. Means it is a line terminator. We can say that it is a line terminator. So data type and variable. Or you can declare one or more variable, as I told you, that data type variable 1, variable 2, and so on, and semicolon. Okay, for example, if you want to store a data 10 into A, then A is integer because 10 is a non, that does not contain any floating point value. So here the 10 is an integer, so you can define A as integer. Okay, so if you want to store 12.16, so this number contains a floating precision point, that means it contains a decimal point, and for such kind of number, I had told you that we have to use the float data type. Means if you want to store this number in a B, so you have to declare the B as a float. Right? Now, if you want to declare the variable, more than one variable, but that must be a similar type. That means you can declare int a comma b comma c, okay, or float a comma b comma c. Okay, again, one thing is also, you can initialize value at the time of declaration. That means you can also write the statements like int equals to 10, comma b equals to 20, comma c is equals to 30, and so on. Okay, so you can write this kind of declaration also. This means you are initialize the value at the time of declination. Okay, so I hope you understand the declaration of variable. Okay, so in our next lecture we will we take some examples, means for to understand the statements and the expression and the operator in C, and then we will learn some operators and expression in C.